So it is Monday night. We are already at the hotel in Caracas, Venezuela. And what happened is that I conducted an interview with Nicolás Maduro. I asked him if I can call him either a president or a dictator, because as you know, millions of Venezuelans don't consider him a president. Then we discussed the fraud that happened here in May 2018, also the reports of torture and human rights abuses and political prisoners. And at the end, I showed him a video that I personally took last Sunday of three kids behind a trash truck looking for food. And he just couldn't stand it. He didn't want to continue the interview. He tried to close my iPad where I showed him the video. And then he said the interview was over. It was about 17 minutes of interview. After that, their Minister of Communications, Jorge Rodriguez, told us that they didn't authorize the interview and they confiscated all our cameras, four cameras, all our video, all our cell phones, and we were thrown out of the presidential palace. But before I left the palace, they took me into a security room with producer Maria Guzman, and they asked for our cell phones. I didn't want to give them my cell phone, so they turned off the light of the room, and a group of agents came in. They took forcefully my backpack, my cell phone. They did the same thing with Maria's, and they forced us to give them our passcodes for the cell phones. We didn't know what was gonna happen to us back then, nor what was happening with the rest of the group. We were a group of seven journalists. And after 2 hours of being detained, because we couldn't leave the palace, 2 hours of being detained, they allow us to leave the presidential palace. They didn't give us our equipment, nor our material. And still at this point, we don't have a cell phone or the interviews. I think we'll never have that interview again. They don't want the world to see what we did.